Hi, I'm Jared, back for another experiment with air pressure. Lesson three, this one is full of action. It involves needing a newspaper and rulers. One caution, some of the rulers you get have a metal strip in them. You want to stay away from the metal strip because that could cause some problems later. So just a very simple wooden ruler. No plastic, wooden works the best. And what I want to do, again, is just emphasize that air has pressure. So I'm going to need a sheet of newspaper, not the whole thing. You want the sheet that opens up into a full spread. So I have my full spread, and I'm going to place it with the fold facing up. What is pushing down on that newspaper? Air. All the air in this room is pushing down on top of this newspaper. So can air be strong enough to break this ruler? Well, if I hit this ruler without the newspaper on top, there is some air pushing down, but not a lot. It's not going to counteract my force of hitting down. There's some air pushing down here. I push down here, the ruler's going to flip. So how can I increase the amount of air pushing down? Well, I give a greater surface. So using this paper, now I've increased my surface area of the air pushing down. You can see I have all this surface area, the air push down, for the air to push down on. I'm going to smooth it out. I'm going to slide the ruler under. Now, when I strike the ruler, all this air pressure is pushing back against my hip. Is air strong enough to break the ruler? We're going to find out. Here we go. On the count of three, I'm going to hit hard and forcefully because I want to create a seal around the edges of the newspaper. If I hit too slowly, air is going to be able to get under that newspaper and it will not work. So fast, hard. One, two. Whoa. You can see, ruler broken, newspaper, all the air pushing down was enough to break this ruler. Air has pressure.